Hello and welcome back to the Healthcare Uncomplicated YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe to the channel to get all this amazing content every week and also check the previous guests. Today, I have another magnificent guest for you. Let me right away introduce you to Peter Birch. He's CEO and founder of Talking HealthTech. He's also a speaker and investor. Peter, how are you?
I'm good, João. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you so much for connecting and also being here with us today.
It's good to speak again. It's been a couple of months since we last spoke back on the Talking HealthTech podcast. So it's great to come and have a chat here in 2023.
Yeah, brilliant. Thanks for accepting my invite. And the topic today is the HealthTech landscape in Australia. And the first item that I have for you is, what are the characteristics of the Australian HealthTech market?
Sure thing. Australia is, I've worked within the healthcare system within Australia my whole career, and we're kind of like the Goldilocks, right? Where it's like not too big, but it's not too small. We've got a good size population of about a bit over 25 million people now. We've got a very large, like, geographical kind of landscape. But, you know, not as many people per square meter, let's say. So, we've got a good healthcare system overall. Medicare is the public system. So for a lot of people, a lot of healthcare is covered under Medicare, so they don't have to pay out of pocket. Some people choose to take private health insurance. But generally, we're quite a lucky country in that we've got a good healthcare system, that the intention is to have it accessible for lots of people. Overall, we do achieve that, but there are still plenty of gaps when it comes to health equity and access, whether it be for disadvantaged communities, but also those in rural and remote areas, given just the size of the country. So lots of challenges where there's this great opportunity for technology to help address them.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for that brilliant overview, Peter. Health equity is a big thing, and I work globally, as you know, and I have a big focus on the United States market, and health equity is really an issue around the world, but in certain demographic countries is really a problem. Moving on, can you share some exciting trends, please?
Sure. Some exciting trends in the Australian health tech landscape. Look, we've got some really interesting innovations that come out of Australia. One thing that Australia is really good at is that early stage research side of things, the R&D or getting new ideas out of a lab, whether it's in the biotech and life sciences side. So a lot of cool innovations come in that early stage. One thing that Australia needs to do better at generally, and we talk about this a lot on the Talking HealthTech podcast too, is taking those ideas from, you know, the lab or from a concept to actually commercialize them as a health tech startup, or to actually get them into a clinical setting or a hospital. So we're certainly seeing some improvement in terms of the landscape, the different funding mechanisms for startups, or a lot more accelerators and incubators. And venture capital and all this kind of stuff. But it's still this funny stage where often there's Australian innovators feel like for them to have a real meaningful impact, they have to go outside of Australia to be able to demonstrate it, where, you know, perhaps to the UK or the US or, you know, to throughout Asia, because there's so many more people there. And depending on what problem they're trying to solve, they can probably have some more success, unfortunately, in other parts of the world, when really, as an Australian, we'd want to keep them in Australia for as long as possible and keep that there. Look, some of the innovations specifically, you know, to your question around what are those technologies that we're seeing that are, you know, causing a lot of interest, maybe even hype. Of course, artificial intelligence, we wouldn't be doing a health tech podcast in 2023 without mentioning artificial intelligence, would we? So there's a lot of interest in that, and has been for a long time. There's some really cool innovators here in Australia that are doing some great stuff with diagnostic AI with, you know, assessing images, whether it be in radiology, some cool stuff in dermatology as well. And a lot of those innovations are coming from within Australia. So that's really fun to watch. And there's some cool VR companies that I've got my eye on here in Australia too. I think there's this great opportunity for virtual reality to address some specific needs in healthcare. And it's a funny one too, where VR, it has such potential, but it's just a difficult one to get kind of, I guess, a broader adoption. But when you think in specific use cases in healthcare, for example, those situations where there are really specific cases that might only come up once a year for a clinician that might be life or death for a patient. So, you know, they don't get many opportunities to practice it. All they've done is read it in a textbook. And then all of a sudden they're faced with a situation in real life. To be able to experience that in a much more immersive way by using VR in that training capacity. There's a couple of companies here in Australia that are doing some cool things there, whether that's in like training for surgery, but also for first responders. So, you know, you think of those that might be paramedics that might be coming onto a situation, or, you know, even bomb technicians, like, so outside of healthcare. So those that are in, like, you know, situations that they need to be able to respond quickly, and to be able to have done that, they kind of need to have experienced it before. So really cool uses of VR here in Australia. And I get excited when I see not just, you know, startups that are creating some of these technologies, but when there are actually hospitals that are using it in real life on a day-to-day. Recently, my son, he's fine now, but he had to go to the emergency department and had to get his cannula done, you know, like, you know, in through the thing. And he's 6 years old, and not many six-year-olds are a huge fan of needles, but he got to do the VR headset while he's in the bed. And I think there was, you know, a story about how there was a bee or a superhero thing or something that was a distraction. So the distraction therapy side, to be able to allow him to, you know, get what he needed there. I think there's some really cool opportunities for stuff like that to fit in with the day-to-day workflow of healthcare, but hopefully make it easier for patients or a better experience for patients, and hopefully take some of the pressure off the healthcare system to allow it to see more people and do it in a sustainable way, because burnout is very much a big issue amongst healthcare workers here in Australia as well.
Mm. Brilliant. Peter, thank you so much for this overview. I like what he said at the beginning. It happens a lot with innovators going out of the original country to get traction. And yeah, it happens in UK, it happens everywhere. But also this amazing overview that you gave around the emerging technologies, practical examples, true use cases. I like the example around your son where VR takes you to another dimension to get away from the pain, and these are really practical examples that are happening on the ground, which is great, because we see a lot of innovation sometimes doesn't hit the ground, on for one reason or another there is no adoption. I remember, like, in 2013 when Google Glasses came out, was the wrong time, also the wrong price point, nobody wants to use it. But things are evolving now and changing really, really fast, which is very exciting for healthcare.
Isn't Apple planning, aren't there rumors Apple are coming out with their VR thing? They're putting a lot of investment into the Apple VR headset. So that'll be interesting to see whether they get their timing right. And
Definitely the time is a bit more right now, I think. But we will see. Time will tell.
We will see.
And moving on, in your Talking HealthTech podcast, you have built a membership community. Can you tell us more, please?
Sure thing. So a bit more context. The Talking HealthTech podcast has been around for quite a while, and anyone can listen to it on their favorite podcast player. It started as an audio-only podcast, so you can listen while you're out on a run or driving. It's funny, people say to me, I'm too busy to listen to podcasts, but it's like, that's the perfect opportunity. You should listen to a podcast because you're too busy, because you can listen while you're doing other things. So we've grown a great audience of people who are interested in innovation in healthcare, which has usually got some kind of use of technology, but also some of those issues that relate to it. So clinical governance and entrepreneurship and innovation, and some of those issues that we talked about before, workforce burnout, adoption, workflow. So these are all, you know, the impact that technology has, or how technology might be able to play a role. Sometimes we speak about really specific topics that are, you know, front of mind in healthcare. You know, how can technology improve access to healthcare for people with a disability, for example, or address those challenges for people in rural and remote parts of Australia? So we talk about that on the podcast a lot and regularly feature guests. I've done over 330 something episodes of the podcast now at the time of recording this, and we do two episodes a week. So by the time it comes out, it might be 350, who knows? Mm-hmm. So lots of episodes to check out there, and anyone can view that, can listen to that for free. We're also doing many more video episodes now that we're able to, obviously doing a lot of virtual ones like this, but also out and about at HealthTech events. So there's, you know, trade shows, or even just being able to go onto a university campus and speak to some researchers, or get a tour of a lab and kind of take the viewer through that episode, but also turn that back into an audio episode. So lots of interesting stuff to watch there, and that's free for anyone to get across. So, but then those people who want to take things to the next level or continue those conversations with a lot of the guests that we have on the show, or perhaps just, you know, really wanting to invest in either themselves or the company wants to invest in more visibility for their brand, we've created the THT Plus membership. And that is where we have just over 100 companies that are THT Plus members, and you can view those on our website, but also 300 and something individuals that have, you know, joined on their own accord. And they are everywhere from, you know, clinicians who are thinking of starting their own health tech solution, or they want to work for a health tech company perhaps one or two days a week, or they're just interested about how the technology might shape the way they do medicine, or the way that their clinic operates. We've got, you know, CIOs and people in the public health space, investors. So one thing, the reason it all came about in the first place was I was working within the industry, and I still do quite a fair bit in the industry of, I guess, health tech here in Australia. And one thing that always I found as a challenge and would almost frustrate me was that it can often feel like a very isolated industry. Like working within it, you feel like you're quite isolated, and it's difficult to get others to open up, you know, quite cold, or like everyone is quite close to their chest with ideas because they're afraid that, you know, their IP might leak or that someone might steal their idea. But I've always taken the thought that, you know, there's so much more benefit in collaborating and having a conversation and sharing ideas and challenges that you're having, because really the chance of actually someone hearing your idea and not just going, oh, that's a good idea, but then somehow accelerating past you and having more passion to beat you at creating something, it's just not going to happen. There's so much more, but you know, you lose out on all the benefit of being able to bounce ideas off someone, find new connections. And in the end, we're all trying to do the same thing, which is improve patient outcomes and reduce, you know, the strain on the healthcare system through the power of tech, because we all need healthcare at some point. So the membership certainly speaks to those points in that mission, that drive. It helps us continue to do the podcast on a day-to-day. This is my full-time thing. So it's not like there's, you know, hey, you know, listen to the podcast and this. Be part of the membership community and continue to contribute. And we're looking at more ways to bring on members onto the show and make it really about the community, which I'm hoping can then broaden out to not just being in Australia and New Zealand, but other parts of the world as well.
Brilliant. That's fantastic. You built something really special there. So well done and congratulations on that. And thanks for having me back in your show back in December 2022, as we were discussing before the recording.
Peter, yeah, well, on that point, you know, that discussion around wearables, that generated, I've had quite a few people speak to me about that episode since then here in Australia as well, because that topic around, you know, the point around wearables, I probably could have brought that up as one of the technologies that are creating a lot of interest, because putting the power back in the patient's hands and giving them that ability to, you know, understand how they can impact their own health, but also give those clinicians that remote access, that is very common. So the conversation was very much on point. Thank you for making the time.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah, wearables is certainly a very hot topic in healthcare. Peter, thank you so much for your time, for this amazing insight, the overview, all your work in the health tech space. I have one little thing to finish off, which is not really a question, is a big challenge question, but I'm looking for a short, sharp answer, please. And it is, how can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
I think I'm going to use my own saying, which is collaboration starts with a conversation. It all just starts with one conversation with somebody and build from there.
That's brilliant. I really like that. And you kept it very neat and simple, which is it's difficult.
That was the brief.
This is so great. Yeah. Peter, thank you so much. Look, I'm going to round up now. Thank you so much for being in here and all the great work that you do in the industry.
João, Bocas, thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, follow Peter's great work. I'm going to post all his links here about the Talking Health Tech podcast, his LinkedIn, his socials. Connect with him about the Australian market and also beyond that. And I'll see you all next time.